What's going on, everyone? Jason here. Thanks for watching this video. Recently, as in last night, I had a buyer reach out on an item that I had on eBay. They were considering purchasing an additional item and asked if I would combine shipping. What are those items, you ask? Well, let's take a look now. So I had the Sakura Sonoma plate set of four dinner plates that I was asking $28 plus shipping of $15 for this set, and the buyer wanted them. Now, in the description of this particular item, I said excellent condition, no chips or cracks. But they reached out in a message and asked if there were any like fork scratches or utensil scratches on the front of the plates. And they also noticed that in the description I had listed soup bowls. And they were clarifying just to make sure these were in fact dinner plates, not soup bowls. So I went ahead and sent photos of all four of those plates showing the face and showing that they were in fact in great condition, didn't have a lot of scratches on the front, so that they could buy those. But I also wanted to take this opportunity to try and sell something else in my store. I also had these four bowls, same print, obviously that goes with the set. So I told this person that I was actually selling saucers, bowls, and plates, and that I had forgotten to switch the listing to say dinner plates when I created this separate listing. I said that for two reasons. One, to let them know that they were looking at the right item. They were dinner plates. And the second reason why I had obviously let them know this is because I wanted to make a sale on either these bowls or saucers or both. And lo and behold, this person accepted my offer of $28 plus $15 shipping and asked in a message if they bought the bowls, if I would combine shipping and give them a discount. Well, of course I'm gonna give them a discount. I wanna make the sale on those bowls as well, and I wanna save them some money to incentivize them to go ahead and purchase. So on this video, I'm gonna be showing you exactly how to combine shipping so that you can send one invoice, they can make a payment, and it's very easy for the buyer in this case. So let's go now and I'll show you exactly how to do this. From my eBay page, I'm gonna go to awaiting payment because this buyer has not paid. I'm gonna select the two listings that I'm going to be combining the shipment on. Obviously, if I had more than two, I would select all that apply. Next, I'm gonna select send an invoice. Now, when I do this, you see that both listings pop up, a set of four plates, the set of four bowls. You can see the pre-shipment amount for 22 for the bowls, 28 for the plates, $50 total. And then the shipping amount of $27 total on this shipment. So if I didn't combine the shipping on this, the buyer would be charged a total of $77 for this particular order. As you can see here in the listing, I put priority mail, but of course I can change that to FedEx or UPS, depending on the rate, as long as it's gonna get there at the same time, if not faster, than what I originally told the buyer. So if you wanna change shipping on this, you're gonna click on this little calculator button right here. And it's gonna open up a new page. This allows you to insert the package details, the dimensions and the weight, so that you can go ahead and send that one price to the buyer. Just keep in mind that if $27 was the all-in price for shipping to the buyer, and obviously if I'm gonna combine the shipment, I need to send them less than that in order for this to be a deal for them. So on this top box, I'm gonna go ahead and select package. And this next section is very important that you get the dimensions right. If you don't know the box you're using, then pause right now, go find the box, and then come back and do this when you have the accurate dimensions. I'm gonna be using a box that is 12 inches by 12 inches by 10 inches. It's not irregular, so I don't need to worry about checking that box. Obviously, weight is also very important. You wanna make sure it's accurate, so make sure that you know exactly what that weight is gonna be, or you may not charge enough to the buyer. In this case, like I said, the plates and the bowls by themselves are 10 pounds, 10 ounces. Now, I usually will factor in for bubble wrap in a box, a pound or so. In this case, I have a pound and 6 ounces. I don't think I'll go over that, so I'm gonna go ahead and put in 12 pounds, 0 ounces. When it comes to shipping, the carrier is gonna go ahead and round up to the nearest pound. So in this case, I don't need to worry if it's 11 pounds, 14 ounces. Really, I just don't wanna go over 12 pounds. So if it turns out being 12 pounds, 1 ounce, I will have to be charged for the rate that is 13 pounds. So I'm pretty confident I can get this in 12 pounds or less. Next, I'm going to put in my zip code. And if you have any handling fees, you know, maybe you wanna charge here for supplies that you're using. I'm not gonna charge anything, so I'm gonna leave this blank, but that's what you could do if you want to. And you can see here in this last box that it populates the buyer's zip code into this last box. I'm gonna click calculate shipping, and you'll notice that it up here at the top, it's got all the dimensions I just put in. The package, 12 by 12 by 10, 12 pounds, 0 ounces, no handling fees, and the zip code that I'm shipping from. And it gives me three options, priority mail, FedEx, UPS. Now I'm gonna go ahead and compare all three of these to make sure I give the best possible rate to the buyer while also not compromising shipping time. Now, one thing I want to point out, you can see here on this rate type, looking down here at this middle portion, it's already selected eBay rates. I've got two options, in-store rates or eBay rates. You may not be familiar with this, but eBay rates are going to be better than the in-store rates. I want to give the buyer the eBay rate. I want to give them the best deal possible. I don't want to try and charge them for something that they don't need to be charged for. So I'm going to keep it eBay rates. It's going to be the cheapest. Now, if I scroll down for priority mail is 2 to 5 days, it's going to cost me $34.99. Remember that I charge $27 for combined shipping. So obviously if I send them this for $35, they're going to be like, what the heck? This is actually more than what I agreed on. So in this case, we're going to do a little shopping around to make sure that I get the best rate. Next, I'm going to select FedEx. Now this first option, SmartPost and home delivery, are usually the two that get there the same time as UPS Ground or Priority Mail. And you can see that SmartPost is going to be $25.62. So already we're doing a lot better than Priority Mail. So I could go this route and save them $1.50, or I could go FedEx Ground or home delivery for $20.76. So you can see we're getting better here. This would save the buyer a little under $7 to select this option. And then our last choice will be UPS Ground. If I scroll down here, you can see UPS Ground is $15.51. If you remember, I was charging $15 just for the plates and an additional $12 for the bowls. So if I send this to the buyer, $15.51, they're going to be ecstatic that they're almost getting free shipping on that second purchase. So for this shipment here, I'm going to go ahead and select UPS Ground because it gets there in 1 to 5 days. And remember, Priority Mail is what I originally chose, which gets there in 2 to 5 days. So we're not gonna be losing any time here. Now you can see here, I've selected UPS Ground. This is the option that pops up under selected services. This should say something to the effect of offer shipping method or offer shipping or something here instead of close. And if it does say that for you, go ahead and select that and it will pre-populate that into the order. But for some reason, it's not showing that for me. So I'm just gonna remember that it's UPS Ground 1551. Now I'm gonna go back to the order. I'm going to select UPS Ground and fill in 1551. And once I do that, it's going to automatically update the buyer's total from $77 to $65.51. And then next, you have the option to enter in a message to the buyer before you send this invoice. So you can see here, I've entered in my message. Thanks for your purchase of the dinner plates and bowl set. I've combined the shipping to account for this package. Once I've received payment, I will ship this out. Thanks again and have a great day. Now I'm going to go ahead and select send invoice, and just keep in mind that when you do this, it's going to send it to the buyer. So make sure that you've entered in everything correctly and this is exactly what you want the buyer to see. So I've reviewed it, I'm ready to send, and I'm going to click send invoice. And confirmation, the invoice has been sent to the buyer. Now I'll just wait for their payment before I ship this item out. So what happens if the buyer's already paid for all the items and you'd like to go ahead and give them a discount on that shipment? I can show you an easy way to do it, and this is how I do it for cases like this. Let's take this first one, for example. I've already shipped this. You can see it was shipped out yesterday. These Tommy Bahama cargo shorts, it doesn't matter what they are, but let's say that this was one of two items that a buyer purchased. So if you want to send a refund, you'll come in here and select this drop-down arrow. You'll go down and you can see the send refund option. I'm going to click that. Now on this page, you're going to see refund the buyer, and you're going to select the reason that you're given the refund. I would select shipping discount and then type in a simple message. So I would type that in here, and then I would go ahead and choose the refund that I'd like to give. And let's say that the shipment was $5 less than what I charged. I can go ahead and put in a refund of $5, and you'll see $5 is the refund that will go through when I click review refund. Now, for the sake of this video, I'm not going to do this because I don't want to send this buyer a refund, but that's how you would do it if you wanted to give a partial refund as a shipping discount. What a coincidence. I just had a buyer come and make an offer on two shirts, and I just accepted both. So as I'm recording this video, it's happening live. There you go right there. Two shirts that just went to the same buyer. Offer accepted. So that's how you combine shipping. I hope this was beneficial to you, and if it was, hit that like button, guys. I really appreciate it and it helps me out. And if you're looking for more videos like this to help you on your reselling journey, you know what to do. Hit that button. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope you have a great week. We'll catch you on the next video. See ya.